Hey Brady, we are going to talk about Euclid's fifth axiom, the parallel postulate. Really what this axiom is about is the story of a revolution about 2,000 years in the making. So the axioms, there are five, and the axioms are about geometry, so geometrical figures. Okay, let's start with number one. Let the following be postulated. Okay, one. To draw a straight line from any point to any point. We have points and lines, and we can connect between two points. We can connect the points with a line.
All right, that's pretty simple. All right, what next?
Okay, number two, to produce a finite straight line continuously in a straight line. So this might seem a little unclear. What's happening is that we're creating a plane. Think of a line segment, that's a finite straight line, and we're gonna continuously move it in a straight line. That gives breadth. So we have from a line to moving it in a line, we get a plane. Now we've talked about points and lines and we've created a plane, we can move to circles. To produce a circle with any center, that's a point, and any distance or radius. We've gone from points and lines and planes to allowing some other objects to live in our world, circles. The first three seem straightforward enough. Number four, things start to get slippery. Number four is that all right angles are equal to one another.
Well, that's gotta be the most obvious of all of them. Why do we even need to say that?
What a right angle is requires definition, and Euclid actually starts by defining what points and lines and these basic objects are. But the notion of equality is more subtle because do we mean equal in the sense of is, or this is exactly the same as that, or a notion of congruence?
We got four. Now we're coming to the fifth. This is the one that we should be paying attention in.
That's right. So here comes the fifth. The fifth postulate. Let's write it down the way Euclid wrote it, and then we'll decide for ourselves what it means. That if a straight line falling on two straight lines makes their interior angles on the same side, stay with me, less than two right angles, then the two lines, if produced indefinitely, meet on the side which are the angles less than two right angles.
It's not catchy, is it?
No, there's a lot of words, wordy. And let's see what it means. Two straight lines, for instance. We're gonna put a third one in, which lies on top. Now, the wordy bit about the interior angles being less than two right angles, are those interior angles there? And then the axiom says if these two lines are extended, then there will be a point where they meet.
Ah, so if these aren't 90, they're gonna crash.
That's right. An equivalent way of saying this statement is the following. So if you have a line and a point not on that line, let's say here, then there exists one and only one line through this point parallel to the given line. Any other line that we draw will eventually intersect the given line. So immediately this stands out, this axiom stands out from the others, and it's just in its wordiness and the fact that it's not completely straightforward. He was kind of aware of this and that he used it reluctantly, and even in the analysis of deducing other propositions in the elements, he waits to use this axiom as long as possible.
It's his axiom of last resort.
Yes, and although when we write it down, we can think this is we can understand why you take it as an axiom, and it seems very straightforward. And so here's the amazing story, the 2,000-year-old story of this revolutionary idea. The fifth turns out to have this kind of departure into other worlds. The first two had to deal with lines, points, and planes, and the third had to do with circles. Number four is also, there's some more hidden things there, but the fifth, this notion of parallelism is turns out to be the key in kind of unlocking new and mysterious worlds. In 1830, independently, two mathematicians, a Hungarian, Bolai, and a Russian, Lobachevsky, they independently discovered what we now call hyperbolic geometry, And the fifth axiom, so we can write maybe 5 prime, can be stated like this. Given any line and a point not on that line, there exists infinitely many straight lines through that point parallel to the given line. So parallel meaning not intersecting.
A moment ago, we drew something that showed there was only one parallel line. Now you're saying they're infinite.
That's right.
Where can these be drawn? What does this look like?
So this new world is the hyperbolic plane which they've created. Well, I actually said out of nothing, I have created an entire world. So now it turns out that straight lines in the hyperbolic plane in this model of the hyperbolic plane look like this. Well, Euclidean vertical lines that intersect this boundary at 90 degrees, or Euclidean circles centered on the real line. So centered at the real line means that we would intersect at 90 degrees. So these are straight lines in hyperbolic space.
So that's a straight line too?
In a hyperbolic plane, that's right. Doesn't look like it, but it is. Okay, so let's take this as our given straight line. And let's take this point as the point not on the straight line. So we've drawn one straight line parallel to the given one. And parallel in that they don't intersect.
But now so that line is parallel to that line?
Yes, that's right. We said parallel lines are lines that don't intersect. So they don't intersect. With our hyperbolic eyes, or the hyperbolic metric, these lines are indeed straight and they don't intersect, so they're parallel. And now, through this point, we can draw another straight line that is parallel to this. And we can draw another. So all these circles are perpendicular to the boundary and going through this point.
It's an unfamiliar thing to most people, and it certainly behaves quite differently than Euclidean space. So at first it's confusing, but I think you can get used to it fairly quickly if you think about it.